nematodes are common and crucial for soil health. But modern cropping practices have interrupted natural nematode interactions, creating a dominance of plant parasitic nematodes. In WA, they're spread throughout the grain belt region.
So the root lesion nematodes, unfortunately for us, do eat the roots. So they actually feed on the roots of our major crops, particularly here in Western Australia, which is wheat, barley and canola.
Above ground symptoms can be deceiving. They're similar to the fungal root disease Rhizoctonia, with crops appearing nutrient or water deficient, and they are. These nematodes feed on root tissues, and if seasonal conditions are conducive, nematodes multiply and compromise growth and could cause yield loss of up to $200 million in a bad year.
The nematode itself actually travels into the roots, and they actually feed inside the root lesions, feed inside the roots itself. So we can see that the roots have been eaten, really. They start to lack their lateral roots. We see sometimes they have what we call noodle roots, and you see this thickening of the roots, and basically they're being eaten out.
In about 50% of WA's paddocks, root lesion nematode numbers sit in the medium to high risk level.
The high risk level starts at 15 nematodes per gram of soil, and the medium level can be as low as 2 to 15. So we're talking about a gram of soil. You actually don't need many nematodes when you're talking about grams to start causing an issue.
It's important to know the species you're dealing with, and in WA there are 4. And to find out which species is present, plant or soil samples need to be sent to a diagnostic service for morphological or DNA assessment. At labs like this, specialist technicians identify species based on physical form and structure.
So we're looking at a male that's just shedding its mask.
And as part of its investment, the GRDC contributed to the upgrading of the Predictor B lab so faster soil test results could be delivered to growers, enabling them to plan well ahead for management strategies.
When you get a Predictor B result, it gives you the predicted levels that can occur in the next season. So it is dependent on what variety or crop is sown and also on the season itself.
Predictor B is the only DNA test for root lesion nematodes.
Root lesion nematode can't be eradicated from a paddock. They are a part of the system. So management can involve crop rotation. And when you're looking at cereals, there are certainly varieties that will perform better than others.
Also recommended for use in rotations are lupins and field peas. For mixed farm enterprises, the use of cerradellas as pasture crops, also managing weeds, keeping up crop nutrition and making use of diagnostic services. But getting into the paddock can't be stressed enough.
I would suggest if growers see patchy areas in their paddocks, in their cereal crops particularly, walk out with a trowel, a bucket and some water, take some plants from a healthy looking area, take some plants from one of their bad looking areas, wash them out and look at the roots. Send off a sample. It's worth the small amount of dollars that you spend in sending a sample to a diagnostic services or for Predictor B compared to the large yield losses that can occur if you ignore it.